Hi, I'm Sam Ming. I'm a first year fellow at Scripps. I am here at RWCS, and today I'm going to be discussing a case presentation called granulomatous myositis, back to square one. So granulomatous myositis most often is secondary to sarcoidosis. Sometimes it's idiopathic, sometimes it can be due to an infection. Very rarely it can be due to a paraneoplastic process. So our case starts with a 43-year-old female who really presented as an idiopathic inflammatory myopathy. She had proximal muscle weakness in her upper extremities, dysphagia, arthritis, and an elevated CK. She was hospitalized for it. So eventually they did an MRI, which found myositis in her biceps, which was biopsied and then proven to be non-caseating granulomas. She was discharged on high-dose steroids and eventually started on methotrexate and IVIG. The issue is that she would later develop non-ischemic cardiomyopathy. Her non-ischemic cardiomyopathy got worse over time. Eventually, she was weaned off the methotrexate steroids and was only on IVIG monotherapy when she presented to the hospital for sustained ventricular tachycardia and presyncope. She ended up in an ICU on an ECMO, and eventually they did a repeat cardiac MRI, which confirmed the progression of her non-ischemic cardiomyopathy. Now, for cardiac MRI, what it looks at is basically sclerotic tissue or necrotic tissue that cannot take up the gadolinium enhancement. And that's why you see late gadolinium enhancement on cardiac MRI. We were thinking about her in the framework of an idiopathic inflammatory myopathy that failed IVIG. So then we started her on Rituxan and discharged her. A few weeks after, she had an outpatient PET scan to answer our question, does she still have active inflammation in her heart driving this process? And if we look over at her figure over here, she did. Now, when we look at her PET scan, and then when we think about it in the context of her cardiac MRI, we see co-localization, what I'd like to call it as a chocolate chip cookie model, of where PET scans show you active inflammation, but it should co-localize with the late gadolinium enhancement that you see on cardiac MRI here, which she did. She had a repeat CT scan over here, which showed that she had innumerable micro nodules in her lung. So when we put her back all together, it seems like she actually has systemic sarcoidosis that was undiagnosed this entire time that presented as a muscular sarcoidosis. So interestingly, sarcoidosis has about a 50% to 80% prevalence of granulomas in the muscles. However, it's almost always subclinical and usually it doesn't cause symptoms. But when we think about granulomatous myositis, there was a prospective study where they took 13 patients who were highly suspicious of granulomatous myositis. Eventually, 8 of those patients were actually diagnosed with systemic sarcoidosis. And of those 8 patients, 2 of them only had lymphadenopathy in the lung, and 4 of them actually had some lung parenchyma disease. So at the end of the day, granulomatous myositis, the most common cause is still sarcoidosis. Thank you so much for having me.